I go to the Melting Pot for dinner and they ask me what type of fondue I'd like, I'm going to say I'd like the Sailor Moon Crystal, because it doesn't get any more cheesy than this show right here. And this week's episode definitely took it to brand new cheesified levels. I still loved this episode. In fact, this series is an intense guilty pleasure. The more I watch it, the more I realize this show is just not for me. I'm a huge action junkie, and the action in this series, for a lack of a better word, sucks. It's not very good. It's not very well animated at all. It's really about the dynamic of the characters and the things that they're going through and how ridiculously overblown everything is. That just makes this show so fun to watch. That and it's a time capsule of the 90s. But this week's episode was actually really important because everything is now coming to a head. It looks like we're finally getting to the end of the very first major arc of the series, where the Sailor Senshi are going to fight against Queen Beryl in the evil version of Tuxedo Mask. Queen Metalia makes a big appearance, and even the Sailor Senshi get to fight against their former boyfriend. So there's certainly a lot of action to be had. But throughout the course of the entire episode, I just kept laughing at a lot of ridiculous moments. In particular, when they decided to fight against Queen Beryl. And what I really did love about this episode is we get to learn more about her backstory. Apparently, she was also in love with Endymion and lost to Sailor Moon's original counterpart. And because of that, she decided to sell her soul to Queen Metalia and become the evil Queen Beryl, who has aspirations of taking over the world. Cue M. Bison speech. You get the whole shtick. But what's really cool is she gets to use her hair like a weapon, and I really love the world that they're fighting in. It looks really unique, and I just love the color scheme of it all, especially when she uses her hair powers, which turns black and has this red outline, and then Venus summons the sword like freaking He-Man and kicks some ass. Venus is definitely, I think, my favorite member of the Sailor Senshi thus far, but that's mostly because she seems to be the most competent, and even then, she still gets her ass handed to her every now and then. But they are able to defeat Queen Beryl by destroying her necklace, which receives its power from Queen Metalia, and Sailor Moon takes the sword, starts running towards her, and hits it like point blank, and it still doesn't break, and they're hanging out there for like a few seconds, and I'm like, why don't you just lop her damn head off and remove the necklace? Would it be that difficult to do that? And then through the use of the power of friendship and love, she is able to power up the sword, it starts to glow, and she's able to pierce through the necklace, killing Queen Beryl, and I find that very surprising. I didn't think she was going to be killed instantly like that, which, frankly, I'm kind of disappointed. She seemed like a much more interesting villain than pretty much anyone else from the entire series. And I don't know what's going to happen with Queen Metalia, because she's basically just a big ghost fart with a face. Speaking of demonic gas monsters, Queen Metalia decides to bring Tuxedo Mask back to the Dark Kingdom, and he escapes through a portal, and Sailor Moon gives chase, and they arrive at the Dark Kingdom, which, surprisingly enough, is at the North Pole. So that technically makes this the Sailor Moon Crystal Christmas special. Yep, the Empress of Evil happens to live at the same place as Santa Claus. As messed up as that is, it's not as messed up as the end of this week's episode, which is very Romeo and Juliet-esque, as Sailor Moon decides to not only kill Endymion, Tuxedo Mask, and also kill herself with that badass sword. And this is just after all of the Sailor Senshi were fighting against their former boyfriends, who literally get saved and revived and get their old memories back, and then they get suddenly killed instantly by Queen Metalia in what might be one of the most anticlimactic death scenes I've ever seen, but they can still communicate with the Sailor Senshi. I guess they have the Force or something. So this week ends with possibly the deaths of Tuxedo Mask and Sailor Moon, although let's face it, they're not going to die, they're the main characters of the series, and there's multiple arcs to go. What I am going to say is, I can't wait to see what's going to happen in the next episode, because it's clearly probably going to be a battle between the Sailor Senshi and Queen Metalia. I can't wait to see what they're going to do when they're fighting against a big freaking dust cloud. So, what's the rundown on this week's episode of Sailor Moon Crystal? Damn, it was cheesy! But it was good cheesy. It wasn't a bad episode by any stretch of the means. It just got this weird sense of humor that I can't quite get behind, but I always laugh at the unintentional stuff, like the scene where Sailor Moon was breaking Queen Beryl's necklace. To me, that was just hilarious. She could have easily just turned the sword sideways and cut her damn head off. I don't know why she didn't do that at all. Maybe that would have been just way too violent and over the top for something like Sailor Moon, but frankly, I think it would look badass. The only thing I don't really like about the episode is I actually don't like when they insert action into Sailor Moon anymore. I actually rather just prefer to see the characters interact with each other, and that's only because the action in this series is just not that entertaining. It's really nothing special. It's basically just a bunch of flashing lights, and that's about it. Like, the Sailor Senshi, they all have these attacks where they yell out at the same time, "Power!" and then they, like, launch shit. But it's always just a big ball of light and other ones that are combining together. And they all seem to have, like, the same purpose. They can heal people, they can destroy them. It's kind of strange. And really, the end confrontation between Sailor Moon and Tuxedo Mask, it's trying to get at me. It's trying to get at my heartstrings, but there's no way that's going to happen. And you'd think a scene where Sailor Moon takes a big fucking sword and shoves it through her abdomen, there'd be, like, at least one speck of blood. Not one. This is definitely a show for the younger crowd. But, like I said, that doesn't make this show bad. It's highly entertaining. It's got a great cast of characters who are hilariously quirky and over the top. Like I said, this is a time capsule of a series, and one that you should definitely check out if you really liked Sailor Moon back in the day, or if you're a fan of the manga version. Like I said, the show is laughably bad, but it's not horrible. It's definitely a fun watch. But this week's episode, I think, felt a little rushed, especially with the death of Queen Metalia. But we're actually getting to the end of the first arc, and I'm really interested to see where it's going. So I'm going to give this week's episode a 3 out of 5. A pretty good episode that you should definitely check out if you are following the series. Thank you guys for watching my review. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. And before you leave, please tell me what you thought about this week's episode of Sailor Moon Crystal. What did you think about the defeat of Queen Beryl? And what do you want to see from the finale of the first major arc of Sailor Moon Crystal? Before you guys leave, remember, you can subscribe to our channel by clicking on the channel icon right up here. You can also follow us on Facebook and on Twitter.